the day after the Browns lost to the Ravens, Mary Kay, and it is confirmed, as you first reported, Corey Coleman, broken hand, Hugh Jackson confirming that he will need surgery. Not sure exactly how long he's going to be out yet, but it's going to be a little while.
Yeah, I think the surgery already took place today, and that means he will be out a while. Now, they're not sure if they're going to put him on injured reserve or hope that he can come back. They need to get the post-surgery report to find out just what it's all about. Will he be casted? Will he have hardware in there, you know, a screw or whatever the case may be? But very unfortunate for the Browns. Corey was starting to come around. He had a good opener, I thought, against the Steelers. Maybe not the best game this past Sunday, but big blow for the Browns.
Yeah, especially with the way that Kenny Britt has been playing. And of course, now it puts pressure on a guy like Rashard Higgins, who had a big game on Sunday. Ricardo Lewis, who has been the number three receiver. Now they're going to need some young guys to step up in place of Corey Coleman.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, it will present opportunities for other guys. Maybe Kason Williams will get back on the field. Maybe Sammy Coates, Reggie Davis. So all these guys are really going to have to come through. But the receiving core as a whole, like you said, they really need to step up and start making a lot more plays for DeShone Kizer.
And a guy that has a big impact on is DeShone Kizer, who said today, obviously after dealing with that migraine that took him out of the game for a little while, that he thought Sunday was the worst game he's ever played, ever. So that's a big statement from the rookie.
In any sport, and he was a three-star sport in high school, so this was the worst experience that he's ever had. And you know what? I'm sorry, but I do attribute some of this to the fact that he was dealing with this migraine. He shed a little bit of light on it for us today and talked about how he started having symptoms on the one drive that ended with the pick that went off Duke Johnson's hands. He said he just started having vision issues right after a long pass to Rashard Higgins, and he forgot to put the motion in the play on the Duke Johnson pick, and Hugh Jackson eventually noticed something was wrong, and lo and behold, it was the migraine, and here we are today.
So now he's got to try and bounce back against Indianapolis this week. Of course, we'll have plenty of time to talk about that game, but one other thing that would help DeShone Kizer, the running game. It did not get going very, very much yesterday.
No, it didn't. And when you have some issues in the passing game, especially now, this was a very good defense that they were playing. But you have to take pressure off your quarterback. You have to take pressure off your passing game in general by trying to run the ball. And they've got to do whatever they can to get that thing cranked up.
All right. We will have full coverage of the day and the week ahead in Berea, cleveland.com/Browns.